This week at the Internet Cafe, online sports. Meet the ultimate football fan. He built his own website for other fans of the San Francisco 49ers. Into mountain bikes, this is a website just for you. You can now play golf live on the web on this virtual golf course. For surfers, check conditions at great surfing beaches around the world on Surfline. And a look at the three major sports websites from CNN, Sports Illustrated, ESPN, and CBS. Sports Online, this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience.
And by Audio Highway, makers of the Listen Up Player, which provides digital, portable, customized audio, downloaded from the Internet and played anytime, anywhere, on headphones or over a car radio. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise and internet computing news, reviews, features and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. And by Learn2.com, the ability utility.
All right, boys and girls,
Hi, children.
It's a sport. This is thumb wrestling. It's a great sport.
It's a great sport.
Did you win?
This is my favorite sport right here.
I've lost.
You're a couch potato.
I'm a big couch potato.
This is your sport. You sit there and just watch TV.
I like sports I can do. So to me, I always question how come people are so excited about web sports. But I know people
are.
You don't like to watch.
You like to sweat.
Exactly. But there's a million sports sites on the web. So somebody's got to love it. Maybe you guys can enlighten
me. Jane, do you do sports on the web?
See, now you guys are going to be surprised. I actually do use the internet to get information.
Like what?
Well, I like to kayak. So what I do is I go and I check the flows before I pack up my kayak and go down to the river. I find out what the flow's going to be like.
So you can actually log on a website that tells you what the status of the water is in the different rivers.
Absolutely.
Like the surfer guys, you can actually, I mean, actually take a look at the surfer different beaches before they go.
It's fantastic.
That is very cool. One thing I like, I do follow professional sports, you know, baseball, football, all that kind of stuff.
We know.
and if you're a transplant, as many of us are, you still follow the teams when you were a kid. So I'm from Philadelphia, for example, so I follow the Eagles and the Phillies and the Flyers. But when you live out here in another city, you can't read your local paper, and you don't want to hear the local guys who really get into the arguments about what went on. And on the web, I can log on to like phillynews.com and read the local papers and the local talk. So to me, that's a great thing about following sports on a local basis. Even though you're 3,000 miles away, you can still read the local papers. So I think it's cool. A lot of interesting stuff we're going to look at today. Sports on the web coming up on the Internet Cafe.
All right.
Sports on the web.
Yeah, there it is.
Yes.
All right, it's us guys here.
Guy talk.
What are sports? Right. What do guys talk about? Sports.
Yeah.
Okay. I gotta admit, I am not a big sports aficionado and don't follow it much.
Well, when you say aficionado, you know you're not into sports. Sports guys don't say aficionado.
Okay. Whatever you call it, I'm not a sports nut. Okay.
Yeah.
And I know you're pretty into it.
Well, I'm into it, but I think the web is really cool. I would guess next to sex sites, sports sites are probably the most popular money making things on the web.
I won't ask how you know that, but
well, I read it. I read it in Wired magazine. No, seriously, because it really makes sense. You can go there, get information you need. You can get late stuff, current stuff, local stuff. So I think it really adds value there.
And
there's three biggies that you know most people look at.
These are the must-sees if you're
into... Well, there's CBS Sports Line. That's the biggie. Mm-hmm. There's the ESPN Sports Zone. Mm-hmm. That's the biggie. And there's the CNN Sports Illustrated, CNN.
So these are actually traditional sports companies that cover sports and media
companies.
Yeah,
these are heavy-duty media companies that have websites, which are really very complete and very big now. I will go out on a limb and rank them.
Okay.
CBS Sportsline, the best.
Number one.
It's fast. I mean, you go there, this is a broadcast mentality. This is coming out of CBS.
Not fast, but I mean, fast like how? What's different than watching TV?
I mean, you go there and the scores are right there. I mean, if you check, you go on a minute after a game is over, it's got the final results
there.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's really like radio. It's like television. It's like real-time
stuff. It's real-time.
It's quick. You get lots of stuff. I like it for a lot of reasons. They have audio on there that actually works and is easy to deal with. They have arcade sports on there, which is really cool.
And I guess you can get more than like one game going at once. You
everything.
Can see,
they have right. a live okay. scoreboard, which is cool. You know, kind of a little Java applet, which is running. I just think it's really a great site.
Okay,
I
mean, what's number two then?
Number two is ESPN Sports Zone.
Okay.
But I think it's a far down number two. It's very self-promotional. I mean, it's all we're ESPN and we're ABC and we're ESPN and ABC.
So ESPN and ABC are related.
Yeah, they're the ones that run it. Yeah, and I don't think it's good. The
probably good for Monday Night Football though. Would that be something they might have on
it's
there?
It's pretty good for Monday Night Football. But, you know, they claim they have this live cam. You know, I couldn't get it to work.
Okay.
One good thing about the ESPN site, it has health and fitness stuff, which is cool. So it's not just the team sports. You can go on there, you know, do your running stuff and do your.
Find out the diet for these latest.
Third one is CNN SI, and I think it's more SI, not CNN. It's a very slow magazine. I mean, I went on 2 hours after a Monday night game was over. The lead story was still a Sunday game.
Oh,
I mean, that's
so
not the web to me.
No, that's not good.
It does have some nice stuff. It's got some nice search capability on that site. If you're into horse racing, CNN SI has got a lot of horse racing stuff. So if you bet the horses, it's
can you
there.
Place your bets there? Or?
I don't think so.
Not yet.
And now you looked at one that I hadn't seen, which sounds pretty cool. But
Instant Sports. And I kind of liked it. It has a animation of whichever game, baseball game that's going on. You pick it, and you're actually watching the animation happen while the game is really happening. So the players are running around. People are doing catches,
that
making
I like.
Plays.
That
yeah,
right, let's check
interesting.
This check out.
All right.
Now, Jerry, you are a surfer dude, the ultimate surfer dude.
I don't know if I'm a surfer dude anymore, but I definitely am a surfer.
I think there must be an age point at which you can't call yourself a surfer dude any longer.
I don't know, but no, I haven't been called dude in a long time, except by my daughter's little friends, I guess. Dude, you know, so I'm definitely not
now,
a dude.
One of the things that you've got is the Surfline telephone service, but you've also got the Surfline website.
Yes.
Now, what is that all about?
Well, Surfline started about 14 years ago as one of the original 976 numbers, and it, to this day, continues to be. It's the longest continually running 976 service in the world. And it was a phone service that allowed surfers to call in at first light in the morning and find out surf conditions at any beach in North America, updated several times throughout the day. And then we began hiring meteorologists who did surf forecasting, and it became this sort of all-encompassing site where you could find out what the surf was like right now or what it was going to be like in 5 to 10 days from now. And that's what we became famous for. 2 years ago when I discovered the web, it was like somebody told me about television back in 1940. I went click, and the website evolved initially just as a test to see if there was a parallel market for the same information that wouldn't cannibalize telephone service. Turns out that there was, and it hasn't, and it's been quite successful ever since.
So, if you're a surfer, what kind of things would you find at the Surfline website that would be useful?
Well, within, say, a half an hour after sunrise in the morning, you can find out how big the waves are, what the overall conditions in terms of weather, wind, tide information at just about any beach in North America, including the North Shore of Oahu and the South Shore of Oahu.
So now one of the cool things that you have is a live cam as well on a number of beaches.
We have 7 of them now, and we've got several more going in. We have one on the North Shore of Oahu, one in Santa Cruz, California, one in Malibu, one in Huntington Beach, one in Florida at Sebastian Inlet, and did I say Huntington Beach? That's the one at my office.
So
and then I just came back from Costa Rica where I put our first international camera in at a place called Jaco Beach on the west coast of Costa Rica.
Now that must be almost the, is that the largest number of video cams?
As near as I can tell, we operate 7 cameras right now. Manhattan Beach, we have a camera, I forgot that. We have 7 cameras right now. I've just put an 8th in on the south shore of Oahu. So those 8 cameras operated by a single company probably represent the largest number of cameras operated by a single entity. There are probably thousands of cameras, each one individually owned and operated by someone who has a camera looking out of their office or in a lab at school or whatever.
So one of the things is, I mean, from a surfer's perspective, I mean, he or she can have a look at the waves before they go out there, and they've got a really good snapshot of what it's
absolutely
going to look like.
The cameras are totally automated and can take a large number of predetermined photos. So what we do is typically take 5 to 10 photos that we preset And the camera automatically goes on at sunrise in the morning and runs every 1 to 3 minutes all day long until sunset. We constantly change the on and off time to reflect daylight and sunset. And then throughout the day, all of the images are archived so that at any time during the day, for example, you could come in to your home at 10 o'clock at night after working all day long, pitch black, go to our website and look at any one of the beaches that has a camera, pick any hour of the day from sunrise until just before sunset and look at all the pictures that were taken, see one that catches your eye, click on it and blow it up to a full-size image. So you can virtually watch it real-time, in which case the image is just refreshed using a meta tag or a JavaScript
right.
that just changes to each different camera view, or go back and historically review it at the end of the day.
So now it seems to me it's not just surfers that would be interested. I mean, this would
no.
be a boater, windsurfer, all these guys. I mean, there must be a great opportunity for lots of other people
yes,
to see
Yes, in
sites.
Fact, we realized, we started this thing out, obviously the name Surfline and the world from whence we came was surfers. We knew there was a natural crossover between surfers and windsurfers that go to a lot of the same places. But it turns out that increasingly the kind of information that we gather, we're the only people in the world who gather it, and that's because we get paid to do it
right.
as a function of the 976 thing. That information, what's really happening at a beach right now, for example, is valuable to a boater or to just a general beachgoer in many instances.
Even a fisherman. Well,
a fisherman, just people who want to know what's it like at the beach right,
right.
now. I mean, where else can you go
yeah.
and find out what's the weather like at Santa Cruz or Half Moon Bay or San Francisco
right.
and make a decision before you leave the house.
Yeah, it's a great website.
It is. I think it's a great website. I always like hearing somebody else say that. I'm proud of it.
Interesting phenomenon when it comes to sports sites on the web is this whole idea of fan sites, and I found a really good one. It's called the Gold Mine. It's a 49ers fan site, and the guy who runs it is right here. Brian, how you doing?
Great.
Good to see you. I was really impressed with your site. I mean, it's got a lot of stuff. It's well designed, rich information, nice graphics, nice layout. Are you a web designer by trade?
No, not at all.
What do you do for real?
I'm an auto technician.
You're an auto technician?
Yeah.
How'd you figure out how to do all this stuff?
Well, I got myself a WYSIWYG HTML editor and went from there.
Which one did you use?
A Claris homepage.
Really? And you just figured this all out on your own?
Yeah.
That's kind of encouraging for folks that are, my God, I could never do this.
Yeah, I thought it was something that I wasn't able to do at first. But
That's
once
great.
I gave it a shot, it
really
was pretty
now,
easy.
Let me ask you a whole idea. I mean, why did you take this on? I mean, it's a hell of a hobby. I mean, it's going to take a lot of time to run your own 49ers fan website. Why?
Well, I'm a fan of the team. I feel there's information out there that people want to hear, especially people who don't live in the Bay Area like I do.
Right.
The fans from across the country want to find out things about their team, so I'm there to give it to them.
And there's like this whole need after a game to talk to other people, right, and compare notes, and was that a good move, a bad move, why'd they win, why'd they lose. So is there sort of interactive stuff going on your website?
Yes, there is. I had a page up for a little while that had a chat area,
yeah.
More of a message board. That didn't go over real well because of the low traffic, but
yeah.
I get a lot of email from people giving me comments on the page, asking me questions about the team, and I try and give my answers the best I can.
No, I mean, there's got to be a lot of these sites up there, right? I mean, how many 49ers fan sites are there?
Oh, literally 100.
So, I mean, there's a lot of guys doing this kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. There's more coming on all the time, too.
Really? But I'd say yours is really, I mean, you look like a corporate site. You got a lot of good stuff going on there. I'm impressed.
Thanks.
Let me ask you, there's a big issue, though, with these fan sites. I understand that in a lot of the teams and the league are coming down on you guys, and you know, you get a call from a lawyer, a cease and desist, because you don't have the right to do this. Have you had that problem?
Not personally, but I know of people who have. And it's not necessarily them putting up a fan site, but them using copyrighted material. Team names and logos and pictures.
Really, even the logo.
Sure.
So, I mean, you can't put the official 49ers logo up on your website. I saw it.
No? we use them, but we try and be fair, and
yeah.
we're not putting up team pictures or things like that.
But I mean, the deal is this is a business, so I guess the team and the league, they want to run their website and sell their ads and make money, and you guys are draining some traffic off there.
Possibly. We're not making any money off this. We're doing it for the love of the team.
All right, let's talk about what's on your site. If I log on to the Gold Mine, what kind of stuff do I find there?
Oh, you find an interactive page. where you have trivia questions and polls and whatnot.
But I mean, is the current stuff, I mean, like today's the day after a game. Could I go onto your website and find out what happened yesterday in the 49ers game?
Oh, sure. You can find an updated game report, the stats from the game, the updated standings in the division.
Brian's commentary on whether the new coach did a good job and all that kind of stuff?
Exactly.
Yeah, well, like, what kind of stuff would you put up there?
Oh, boy. God.
That was good, that was bad, that was a stupid move, or...
I'll give my comments as far as, you know, this player's really showing up big in this game. This player's not really doing his job. Give the fans' perspective on it rather than the media's perspective, because the fans, really, they're a lot more...
So, man, you get email up and back, and you guys chit-chat and argue about, you know, whether something was good, something was bad.
Yeah, that does happen.
How does the whole website compare to just, you know, tuning into a sports talk radio station or reading the sports pages or watching ESPN or something? How is this different?
I think it's something from a fan. And the fan,
people power kind of thing.
Exactly. The fan can relate to other people because I'm just the regular guy.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not an icon there on TV who people watch every single day. So I figure I can relate to these people in a different way.
Yeah. Well, again, it's really well done. So it's called The Gold Mine.
Yes, it
is. All right. Thanks a lot, Brian.
All right. Thanks.
Scott, I am a huge mountain biking fan.
Oh, great.
And one of my dreams is to just take off, never go back to work, and just ride across the country. Now, you're working with this group, Wheels on the Rim.
That's right.
And they're doing something that sounds amazing. Tell me a little bit about it.
Well, there are two riders on the expedition, Jennifer Fox and Patchen Holmitz. They've been traveling for over a year now. They started in Seattle on a mountain bike expedition that's going around the entire Pacific Rim.
The entire Pacific Rim.
That's
How
right.
many miles is that actually to go?
Oh God, I don't even know. It's there are 23 countries I think they're going to hit along the way.
And are they starting in? Where did they start?
They started in Seattle, Washington, United States, and traveled down the west coast of the U.S.
So they're going
Mexico,
the
Central
rim,
America,
sort of counterclockwise, I guess.
That's
it would
right.
Be.
Yeah, and now they're in Asia.
Okay.
Actually.
Now you're helping them in a sense. You've created this website, Wheels on the Rim website, and what are you doing on the rim and on the site, and how did you get involved in that?
Well, the site has been evolving along with the expedition. It started out just text-based. Mostly for family and friends to keep track of them, where they were, how they were doing, through email and messages back
and
So
it was really more for personal, for people who knew them, who were kind of wanting
yeah,
to
that's
see
right.
if they were safe and see if they were having a good time. And
right. then we started getting some photos, and I got the graphics on there, their logo, and now the attention...
They actually created their own logo?
Yeah, the attention has just been incredible.
So people from the outside or just people who were interested found out about it and...
Yeah, mountain bikers, teachers, travelers, the feedback has just been
are all
incredible.
Coming onto the site.
Yeah.
Great. So what are some of the things that are up there that people, you know, really grab their attention?
I think most people like the photo gallery. Mm-hmm. There are shots of the expedition along the way, from them riding to scenery
right.
to people they've met. It's.
Right. I looked on there and saw a few of those, and there's some really fabulous shots. I saw one
incredible.
There in a glacier park in Chile, and I mean, just amazing.
Yeah,
amazing
and one of the sponsors, Seattle Filmworks, has been great. They've developed all the film and gotten it to us on disc, so it's
you can put it right
yeah, really
there.
Easy to get it up there. Right.
So how have you been in touch with them while they're out in all these sort of remote places, and are they able to send stuff to you to put up on the website?
Yeah, they've gotten email to me on a pretty regular basis. Their family and friends have been able to correspond with them.
So they're able to find internet access out there?
Yeah, through public libraries, internet cafes, and other travelers who have either laptops or some sort of electronic device with them.
Really? So all over the world, they're still finding
Yeah, and even people they don't know have contacted them and offered them places to stay or advice on what to see and things to do.
Oh, so they're really, they're using it to the full advantage.
Yeah, the feedback and response has just been incredible.
Richard, I don't know about you, but I'm one of the millions of people who could really use some help with their golf game. Now, tell me what PGA Tour Pro is going to do for my golf game.
I think that PGA Tour Pro can maybe help your golf game as far as setting your strategy, but mostly it'll probably help you with your smack talk with your partners, making sure that you disrupt their ability to have a good golf game and bring them down to your level.
Now let's talk about that partner element, because you have an online element to this, to the software program. So tell me a little bit about how that's put together.
PGA Tour Pro is the first of the major golf games to provide internet services, and is an important and central part of the product. What it tries to do is give you the opportunity to go and play with your friends or people you don't even know on the internet. One of the features allows you to voice chat with them and to share your opinions of their previous shot or lack thereof.
Yeah, I've heard a few comments about my own. Now, that's an interesting thing, because that's one of the big things about golf, is that you get a great relaxing afternoon or a morning with your friends, and you have to tell really bad jokes and that type of thing. So now on this online golf game, you have the opportunity to do that as well.
That's right. If you wanted to play with your father, who happened to live in Washington, D.C., and you lived here, you could get together every Saturday morning and play golf at Pebble Beach and talk about the grandkids, which we all know that's what fathers really want to talk about anyway.
Now, you have the standalone software. And now, how are all the different ways, from a standalone perspective all the way to an online experience, how are the different ways that you can actually play the game?
In addition to being able to play the game by yourself or with somebody else who wants to play on the same machine as you, you can connect to people, direct connect on modem. You can also connect to people through the internet. That process allows you to hook up with different people on different courses who want to play with you at that point in time, or people you don't even know. Allows you to play on a number of courses in a number of different formats, including the skins format or the traditional stroke play that makes up the vast majority of what most people play. In addition, you can participate in tournaments that you can set up or that we can set up for you.
So I can actually go to your server and actually you can find me people to play with?
Or you can create your own tournament, the Cyber Cafe golf tournament, starting tonight.
So anything's possible.
Anything's possible.
Now, one of the things, at least from other games, things like Quake and Doom and those types of things, there's always an issue of time lapses and the immediacy of that of the game when you're doing it over the internet. Is that still an issue for you with a golf game?
Yeah, the first question everybody asks about internet games is about latency and bandwidth. We're kind of blessed. Golf is one of the games that's really well suited to this problem. For us, the latency of a particular shot, when you take your shot, if I don't see it for a second later, that really is of little or no consequence to our ability to have a good time together. In addition, we send so little information on a shot-by-shot basis, you could probably play this game on a 300-baud modem if you wanted to.
Even if I actually have a voice chat with the people I'm playing with, that...
Well, certainly the more you send, the more of your bandwidth that you absorb, but it allows you to send a voice message of pretty much the size of the memory on your machine to somebody else, and it'll squeeze it through when it has the chance.
Now, the game is called PGA Tour Pro, and the fact is you are affiliated with the PGA Tour.
Right. We've had a 10-year-plus relationship with the PGA Tour, which is the major league of professional golf. And so we've had the participation of a number of pros, people like Mark O'Meara, Brad Faxon, Buzzy Zeller, Davis Love III, the winner of this year's PGA Championship.
So you've also got something coming up, which is your online golf tournament that's coming up. Tell me just a quick thing about that.
Yeah, we're going to try and create professional cyber athletes, people who play video games and computer games for money. So starting this fall in early October through early November, we're going to run a 5-week tournament that allows players from all over America to try and participate to win prizes on a weekly basis, culminating with a $25,000 first prize the same week as the PGA Tour Championship. Every one of those weeks, we're going to fly the four best players for that week's tournament to the site of the PGA Tour event that week.
Wow.
And they'll get the opportunity to play for the big cash and take home the big checks.
All right, so I want to know, have you changed sports from the remote control to the web keyboard?
Yeah,
at least
my new
show?
Sports industry is carpal tunnel syndrome. So
to you, a sports injury is carpal tunnel
exactly.
Syndrome.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm kind of a changed man.
Oh, come on.
Oh,
well,
really?
I saw this Wheels on the Rim, these guys that are a guy
cool.
And a woman
yeah.
That are riding around the Pacific Rim, and I think, well, I can certainly get out and ride my bike.
Well,
I
you're a biker. Thing,
I'm
yeah.
A big biker. I love to do that. And
but you would go on the web and watch other people's stories of riding.
No, I actually want to go ride around. Someone else can do the website.
Jane, anything besides kayaking in your purview now?
Professional cyber athletes.
What's that?
That is the next thing. You got to keep on your seats for this, but that PGA Tour software.
Oh, like competing online?
They have, and so just picture this. I may become a professional golfing cyber athlete. Wow. Anything is possible.
All right.
Well, good luck. I can see golf on the web. This, I mean, like, what's the bandwidth? You're going to play tennis on the web? I mean, you know.
Hey, Pong was one of the first games.
Not quite on the web. Well, I'll tell you, speaking of tennis, you know what I really liked about the web? And you talked about the instant sports thing. I remember during Wimbledon, for example, I like to follow tennis. You know, very few games are actually on TV, and I was interested in one particular match. You could go up on the web and follow the action point by point on the web. I mean, it's kind of stupid, but I was just sitting there watching the points come up, but I really cared about the outcome. Yeah. So, I mean, that was cool. Instant sports you talked about, by the way. I happened to go on that website after you showed it to me. You know, they said there's so much traffic and so much demand, like bandwidth crazy, and
I couldn't deal with it.
I had to shut down part of that as cool as it was.
Wow.
This was interesting, Stephanie.
So people.
All right, we're going to see you next week here at the Internet Cafe. Thanks for joining us.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience.
And by Audio Highway, makers of the Listen Up Player, which provides digital, portable, customized audio downloaded from the Internet and played anytime, anywhere, on headphones or over a car radio. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise and internet computing news, reviews, features and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. And by Learn2.com, the ability utility.
To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify show number and topic.